Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the Sahaba, he said, do you know who is the bankrupt person? Do you know who is the bankrupt person? So they said, O Messenger of Allah, the bankrupt person amongst us is the one who, you know, his debts are more than what he owes, basically. He doesn't have anything. That's what the muflis or the bankrupt person is. He's the pauper, the beggar who, you know, he owes much more than he can afford to pay. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no, the real bankrupt person from my ummah is the one that will come on the day of judgment with lots of salah and siyam and zakah. In one hadith, with good deeds like mountains, he's gonna come. But at the same time, he has come and he has cursed one person, and he has slandered another person, and he has eaten the wealth of a third person, and he has shed the blood of another person, and he has hit this person. And so the Prophet ﷺ said, every one of them will be given from his good deeds. This one and that one and this one and that one. Until if all of his good deeds are finished and he still owes things, then what's going to happen? The sins of the ones he wronged will then be put on him, and it will be burdened with him, and then he shall be cast into the fire of hell. This hadith is reported in Sahih Muslim, and it is a terrifying hadith because it shows us you can come with the right amount of salah and siyam and zakah. You can come with the rituals having been performed. You can come and outwardly the people call you pious, but you have harmed too many people, and you have done backstabbings and backdealings, and your tongue has been used to hurt and irritate lots of people. And so all of that will be of no use whatsoever on the day of judgment. And this really shows us the mistakes of those people, and there are unfortunately all too many amongst our community, that sometimes people, they emphasize the rituals so much and they forget the issue of akhlaq and manners. And our religion is the religion of the middle. Neither do we say that the rituals are not more important, nor do we say the akhlaq are not more important. We say the righteous Muslim has both rituals and akhlaq together. We need both of them. And if you only have one and not the other, it will be highly, highly, highly problematic on the day of judgment, because you have not fulfilled the criterion of what it means to be a good Muslim.